Type 0, the silent shift. It begins quietly, no alarms, no sirens, just a whisper in your blood. One cell forgets its duty, then another. A kidney slows, a lung sighs. The heart doesn't skip, but it hesitates. You still breathe, you still speak, but something beneath the skin is beginning to collapse. Organ failure is not a cliff, it's a gentle slope, and type 0 is where the descent begins. There's no diagnosis yet, no test screams, emergency, but the body knows. A dry mouth, slight fatigue after climbing stairs, a bruise that lingers. This is the prodrome, the stillness before the avalanche, and most will walk past it. Example, you feel a little tired for weeks. A cough you thought was nothing hangs on. Blood pressure edges higher than stabilizes. You keep living, unaware you're slowly unraveling. Type 1, the warning echo. Then comes the murmur. The lab tests start to hum their sorrow. Creatinine creeps upward. Liver enzymes light up like distant storm clouds. One organ speaks, a liver whispering through bilirubin, a kidney grumbling through swelling ankles, a heart skipping once, twice, then regularly irregular. It's still early. Doctors call it mild dysfunction, but this is a red sky at morning. Your body is no longer balancing. It is compensating, and every compensation is a loan with heavy interest. Organ failure has stepped onto the stage. Subtle, but present, manageable, but no longer reversible in full. Example, your doctor says your kidney function dropped from 90% to 60%. Your eyes are a little yellow. Your heart flutters just once, but it terrifies you. You start meds. You start watching, but the war has begun. Type 2, the compromise. The second stage feels like a negotiation. Your organs are now bargaining with time. They no longer function. They cope. Every heartbeat is a trade, every breath a balancing act. The lungs gasp harder for the same air. The liver filters less and toxins roam longer. The kidneys filter, but less like sieves and more like torn cloth. Now the body speaks louder. Swelling, nausea, confusion at dusk, sleep disrupted by thirst and breathlessness. You look in the mirror and something looks distant. The lights behind your eyes have dimmed. This is no longer silent. It's not a whisper. It's a drumbeat. Still treatable. Still stable, maybe. But every day is work. Every system is tired. Organ failure is no longer isolated. It spreads like a slow fire. First the lungs, then the heart joins. The kidneys crumble under pressure. Example, you are hospitalized with shortness of breath. Your feet swell, and your urine darkens. Doctors start dialysis just to help for now. You nod, but deep down, you feel the body is surrendering something. Type 3, the cascade. This is when the house catches fire. Multiple systems begin collapsing. The lungs fill, the kidneys shut the tap. The liver spills poison into the blood. Confusion sets in, literal, physical. The brain starts to blur. The clarity you once had becomes fog. This is multiple organ failure. This is where one organ's fall pulls others down like dominoes. No organ works in isolation. Blood pressure drops. Oxygen levels fall. The gut stops digesting. The skin turns clammy, waxy, pale. ICU machines, four lines, and ventilators. The language of type 3 is mechanical. The breathing tube becomes your voice. The dialysis machine becomes your kidneys. The infusion pump becomes your lifeline. Organ failure is now plural. It is no longer a symptom. It is the story. Example, you wake up intubated. You remember nothing from the last 3 days. Your family says your heart, kidneys, and lungs all started failing at once. Doctors use the word shock. You barely escaped it. Type 4, the refractory collapse. This is when the body stops responding. Not because it doesn't want to, but because it can't. Medications no longer lift the pressure. Oxygen no longer calms the lungs. The heart races, then slows, then races again. Your immune system, once a soldier, is now confused. Sometimes it attacks the invaders. Sometimes it attacks you. Sepsis spreads like a silent storm. The blood becomes acid. The lungs stiffen like old leather. The kidneys stop completely. Liver turns jaundice into despair. This is refractory organ failure. When even aggressive treatment fails to gain ground, every intervention becomes more extreme. Every hour becomes critical. Doctors talk in whispered tones. Families sign consent forms with shaking hands. Organ failure here becomes a tide, and it pulls stronger than the machines fighting it. Example, despite antibiotics and ventilators, your organs continue failing. You're on 3 medications just to keep your blood pressure up. A nurse says, "We've done everything." You feel it too. You're drifting. Type 5, the irreversible. There comes a point when the body has spoken its last resistance, when no organ is able to recover. When the machines are no longer bridges, they are replacements, and they are not enough. Brain activity begins to dim. The heart beats only with assistance. The lungs inflate only by force. The kidneys are silent. The liver has shut its gates. Now time becomes an enemy, not of life, but of dignity. This is where families face impossible choices. Do you keep fighting or do you let go? This is the threshold of death, not abrupt, not peaceful, but a grinding mechanical twilight. And still, the body fights. But not for survival, for time, for a chance, for a goodbye. Organ failure is now absolute. It is the end of function, the last breath, though sometimes delayed by a machine, always comes. Example, your brain no longer responds to stimuli. You require full life support. Doctors talk about withdrawal of care. Your family sits in silence, holding a hand that cannot feel them. Type 6. The mechanical afterlife. This is not life, not in the way you once knew it. This is biology surviving without consciousness. Your body is a puppet of machines. A ventilator breathes for you. Dialysis keeps your blood clean. A tube feeds you. A monitor dictates your rhythm. But your mind, that spark that laughed and feared and dreamed, is gone. This is not a coma. This is brain death. Confirmed. Measured. Still, your chest rises. To those who love you, you still look alive, but your brain is dark. There's no perception, no pain, no you. Organ failure here has consumed the master switch, the command center, the bridge between body and soul. This is not death by definition, not yet, but it is the deepest form of loss. Example, a scan shows no brain activity. Doctors perform a brainstem reflex test, no pupil reaction, no gag reflex. The machines keep the body warm, but you are no longer there. Type 7, the delayed echo. Sometimes the body wins, or thinks it does. A transplant, a miracle drug, an ICU escape. You go home, you breathe your own air, you walk under your own sky, but something lingers, a memory in your mitochondria. A scar on your immune system, a permanent limp in your liver function. This is post-organ failure syndrome. Your heart beats, but it tires fast. Your kidneys work, but they falter under stress. Your brain recovers, but you forget the names of your children. Organ failure isn't always a cliff you fall from. Sometimes it's a cliff you survive, but live forever at the bottom of. Example, you survived septic shock. You're off the ventilator, but now you need dialysis twice a week, and sometimes you forget what year it is. Type 8, the recurrent collapse. Some battles don't end in victory or defeat. They become a cycle. Chronic heart failure, recurring liver crises, pulmonary flares, kidney recoveries, followed by plunges again. You become fluent in your lab values. You know the taste of IV saline. You memorize the beep of infusion pumps. This is not living, this is navigating. You are not dying, but never healed. Doctors say decompensated, which means the tightrope you walk is fraying, and every infection, every missed pill, every sleepless night is enough to tip you back into type 3. Organ failure becomes your shadow. You manage it like a bad habit, but it never really leaves. Example, your liver fails every 6 months due to cirrhosis. You're in and out of hospitals. Your skin itches from bilirubin. You keep a go bag packed just in case. Type 9, the organ economy. One organ fails, but others pay the price. The liver breaks down, and now ammonia poisons the brain. The kidneys falter, and the lungs drown in fluid. The heart weakens, and the gut stops absorbing nutrients. This is the economics of organ failure. Every system is taxed. Every crisis demands payment. Your body becomes a battlefield of priorities. Do you fix the lungs at the cost of dropping the blood pressure? Do you increase fluids at the risk of drowning the heart? This is where medicine becomes chess, and every move costs time, or tissue, or hope. Example, you are given steroids to treat lung inflammation. It helps your lungs, but your blood sugar skyrockets, damaging your kidneys. And now you face two failures, not one. Type 10, the collapse of time. This is where organ failure rewrites the clock. Moments stretch, minutes shrink. A single breath feels like labor. An hour waiting for test results feels like a decade. A day without progress feels like a verdict. The body ages faster here. The face hollows. The eyes sink. The skin yellows or grays or turns translucent. Every hour lost in ICU steals weeks from recovery. Every moment in multi-organ distress is a race against irreversible damage. This is not just failure. This is fast-forwarded entropy. Example, you entered the hospital a week ago with shortness of breath. Today, you are on dialysis, oxygen, and feeding tubes. Your hair is falling out, and you don't recognize yourself in the mirror anymore. Type 11, the end stage spiral. There is a level where the body knows it will not recover, and it starts letting go, slowly, rationally. Appetite vanishes, sleep deepens. The body grows colder, blood pressure lowers like a closing curtain. Organs begin shutting down one by one, not in chaos, but in sequence. The body is no longer trying to survive. It is trying to die gently. Palliative care enters. Pain is managed. Breathing is eased. The goal is comfort, not cure. This is not organ failure as a battle. It is organ failure as surrender. Not weakness, but peace. Example, the doctors stop the aggressive treatments. You are given morphine for breathlessness. Your family gathers around. You feel warmth, not panic. The light dims softly. Type 12, the organ legacy. Even in death, the organs can serve. You are gone, but your heart could still beat in another chest. Your liver may cleanse another's blood. Your lungs may breathe for someone waiting in silence. This is organ failure turned backward from loss to gift, from end to beginning. One body ends, but through donation, others continue. It is not rebirth, but it is continuation. Example, your brain has died, but your body remains viable. Your organs are transported. A child receives your heart. A man in his 30s now lives because your kidneys work in him. Final words, a haunting conclusion. Organ failure is not a single moment. It is a progression, a story of cells giving up, systems unraveling, time folding inward. But it is also a mirror of how delicate we are, and how fiercely we try to live. Behind every machine, every number, every beep, is a soul hoping for one more day, one more breath, one more morning with the sun on their skin. And sometimes they get it, sometimes they don't. And that's the truth of organ failure. It doesn't just kill, it transforms. It carves memory into flesh and reminds us how precious one healthy heartbeat really is.